بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters in Islam, how would you like for an opportunity in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives you for all your sins? The sins that the eyes committed, the sins that your ear committed, the sins that your mouth committed of foul, filthy, evil language, and that which you've consumed of haram, the sins of your hand, the sins of your feet. How would you like for an opportunity to have them all forgiven? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that on the 15th day of Sha'ban, which is only 2 days from now, al hadith is an authentic hadith authenticated by Imam al-Albani rahimahullah and others, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَطَّلِعُ اللَّهُ إِلَى جَمِيعِ خَلْقِهِ لَيْلَةً نِصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would look at all His servants, all His slaves on the 15th night of Sha'ban. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He sees us in every moment of our lives. But on this night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees all the slaves and He forgives them. فَيَغْفِرُ لِجَمِيعِ خَلْقِهِ, Allahu Akbar. An entire forgiveness of all their sins, the millions and millions of sins are all forgiven. Except for two types of people. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِلَّا لِمُشْرِكِ, except for a mushrik, a person who has associated partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a person who worships other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such people do not deserve Allah's forgiveness on that day, because you need tawheed, you need to adhere to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and declare that in your life before being forgiven. لِمُشْرِكِ, that's the first category. And the second type of people that are not forgiven, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, مُشَاحِن, أي مُشَاحِن. وَالْمُشَاحِن is a person who holds inside of his heart grudge, animosity, hatred, anger, envy, jealousy towards another Muslim brother or sister. This is a مُشَاحِن. مُشَاحِن from the word شَحَن. يعني شحن, he's charged up with anger and hatred against his Muslim brother and sister. For my brothers and sisters in Islam, clear your hearts and clear the air between you and others, especially family members. You need to do that before the 15th of Sha'ban so that you can be forgiven for your sins. And you need to do that so that once you're forgiven, bi-ithnillah, you're ready to approach Ramadan with a clean heart. As a result, you benefit from Ramadan. This is one of the ways in how we prepare for Ramadan. For clear that heart. Wal-ulama rahimahumullah, like Imam Ahmad, he said, Al-mushahin here, it means man yubghidu ahla sunnah, those who hate ahla sunnah, those who hate the scholars, those who hate their يعني, ulama, these are also considered in the word al-mushahin. And by far, this is the worst type of hate you can have in your heart. Hatred towards the scholars of Islam, hatred towards the people of knowledge, hatred towards those who spread the word of Islam and the message of Islam. Be very careful that you don't have any hatred inside of your heart towards them, because some people don't even consider that to be hate. So be careful, clear that air between you and the people, and love all your mashaykh, love all the ulama that are upon the correct methodology of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And remember and understand that on this day and on this night of the 15th of Sha'ban, there is nothing extra in terms of worship. There's nothing special of worship. So the ahadith that mention, or the fabricated ahadith, the weak ahadith that mention, we need to fast this day, pray its night, all of this is not supposed to be done. These are all innovations, except for a person who has a common routine of praying at night, then he continues to do so. Or someone who has a continuous routine of fasting 13, 14 and 15th of every month, then he can continue to do so and fast on the 15th. But to specialize this day for fasting and praying its night, then this is from the innovations. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam never did that. The companions after that never did that. And until now, nothing has reached us of news that the first of generations ever did such an act. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us upon the sunnah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to clear our hearts from hatred against our Muslim brothers and sisters. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all and to make us ready to enter Ramadan and to give us the ability to worship Him as long as we live until we meet Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innahu waliyu thalika wal qadiru alayhi wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.